Our Father who art in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Deliver us from the evil one. Lead us not in temptation to temptation. For yours is the kingdom, the power, the glory, the love, the honor, the mercy, the praise, the victory, forever and ever. Amen and amen. When Jesus taught the people how to pray that way, he said, this is how you pray. It doesn't need to be all fancy. But when you consider the way he taught us to pray, it is very profound. We just heard it for so many years and have been saying it for so many years that we're desensitized to the power of what he's saying. As I was pondering it the other day, where it says, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, he kind of gave me a different angle to look at that from. A lot of people say that our lives should mirror what's going on in heaven. And that exactly can't happen, because the heavenly realm, the third heaven realm, is perfect, and this one is fallen. But the whole prayer is an invitation to bring that third heaven realm and all of its military assets. That's how I refer to angels, or military assets, to pull it down in. Make changes in this natural realm. But not only that, there's some very practical instructions. And I think the most ignored, non-compliant part of that verse is the part where he said, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. We could say, there's different versions say different things. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Forgive us our debts as we forgive the debts of those Thank you, Lord. So, how many of us are walking around holding grudges, wounded, expecting God to bless us in spite of us, our unforgiveness towards others? Father, in the name of Jesus, every single person that watches this video, whether it be today, next week, a year from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, help them quiet, still send shalom, peace. Perfect, total peace into their hearts so that they can quiet down all the distractions of this work that's going on in the world or around them, and just sit calmly in your presence and listen to you speak. Father, if there's any unforgiveness, bitterness, resentment in us towards people that have hurt us, we're asking for a supernatural touch from you to pull out any bitter root, It was such an extraordinary thing that Jesus went through. So there's not one of us on the face of this earth that can say that we have but been done wrong in greater measure than what Jesus suffered to redeem us back for the Father. Whew. We want your correction, Lord. We want your protection, your direction, your peace, but most of all, that supernatural love that knows no boundaries, that you have thoroughly loved us with. We want to be able to love others that way. Truly love others that way. Our Father, who art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What God was showing me is in heaven, there's no question. Whatever he says is. So Father, we're granting you permission as an act of our will. We want your will done in our lives. Just like your will's done in heaven. That's your domain. There's nothing there to stop your purposes. It's not fallen. It's not broken. There's not a war against it. On earth as it is in heaven, we want your will being done in our lives, just like your will's being done in the lives of the people in heaven. There's no hindrances. So we ask for that supernatural touch. Give us this day our daily bread. That's the word and food, provision. God, we need your forgiveness. And if we're holding any unforgiveness against anybody that's wronged us, we release it to you now. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. There's been some rotten things done to innocent people. Forgiveness is not an endorsement of bad behavior. It's giving us giving up our right to retaliate or to have it hold us captive any longer. We're putting it in your hands, God. We're going to be free and full of joy. You deliver us from evil when we come out of agreement with that. We plead the blood of Jesus. You put us in the sanctification process. And it just makes us hunger and thirst for more of you. And we're grateful. Lead us not into temptation. What that means to me is, God, don't lead me back out into the wilderness. As necessary as the wilderness seasons are, we're glad we're out, Lord. We would have never made it without you. That's where we learn his faithfulness. For yours is the kingdom, which we are members of your kingdom, not this one. The power, the glory, you have the honor, the love. We give you all the praise, God. In Jesus' name, amen.